In this session, we are going to read a very interesting story, the story of tea. Let us begin with a question. Can you name the most widely consumed beverage in the world after water? Perhaps many of you have guessed the answer. The most popular beverage in the world is tea. The fresh aromatic brew with which the people like to begin their day. It has a refreshing, astringent flavor. It is actually made by brewing, that is by infusing in boiling water the leaves and the shoots of the plant whose botanical name is the Camellia sinensis. The leaves are at first dried, cured and processed before they are packed and sold to us. Camellia sinensis is an evergreen plant that grows in tropical and subtropical climates. Tea plants require at least 100 to 125 centimeters of rainfall a year and prefer acidic soils. Many of the world's best tea estates are located on hill slopes at elevation of up to 1500 meters. Now it is said that the tea plants grow slowly and acquire a richer flavor at this height. When the plants mature, only the top 1 to 2 inches of the plant are picked. These buds and leaves are called plushes. The new plush appears on the plant every 7 to 10 days during the peak growing season. Now left to grow on its own, the tea plant may actually grow into a small tree, but in all tea gardens, the plants are pruned and kept at a height of about 3 feet, that is waist high, to enable easy plucking of the leaves. The teas we buy are actually classified according to their leaf size. Accordingly, we have Assam type of tea characterized by the largest leaves, China type characterized by the smallest leaves, and Cambod characterized by leaves of intermediate size. We have three very distinct and different tea growing regions in India. Each of these regions is famous for the special type of tea it produces, which are unique to taste, aroma, strength and flavor. The three regions are Darjeeling in northeastern India, Assam in far northeast India, and Nilgiris in south India. Most people agree that tea is a refreshing drink. It contains no carbohydrates, fat or proteins. Now, what gives tea its special and distinctive flavor is theanine as well as caffeine, which give the drink its stimulating quality. How and when did people first begin to drink tea? An amazing story has come down to us from Chinese legends. It is said that Emperor Shennong, the father of the Chinese agriculture and medicine, was on his travel when a servant was boiling some water for the emperor to drink. Just then, a few leaves from a nearby tree blew into the boiling water. Now the water immediately changed color. Now on drinking the water, the emperor was amazed by the rich flavor and the refreshing quality of the resulting infusion. Excited by the unknown plant and its amazing flavor, he carried out further investigations and discovered that tea had many healing and restorative properties and could also be used as an antidote to certain poisons. Yet another legend tells us that it was a Buddhist monk named Bodhidharma who who was the first to use tea as a drink. He was keen to find a herb or a medicinal plant which would help him stay awake and alert for long periods of time in prayer and meditation. After considerable search and trial, he found that chewing leaves from the tree shrub acted as a stimulant, helping him stay awake. It was he who introduced tea among his disciples in China. It is said that Japanese priests studying under Buddhist teachers in China carried tea seeds and leaves back home with them. Turkish traders also began to bargain for tea on the border of Mongolia. In fact, the story goes that the Chinese Emperor Hui Tsung was so taken up with tea that he set up a research into the best tea whisking methods and also hosted tea making and tea tasting tournaments in the court. So tea-minded was he that he failed to notice that Mongolia had actually taken over his empire. Thus, the habit of drinking tea spread in Japan, Europe, and England, where it became a fashionable and popular drink among the people. How did this magical beverage get its name? The Chinese character tu was first used in early inscriptions to describe tea. But later, a new character, cha, was developed to refer specifically to tea. The word cha is now sometimes used in English to refer to China tea. And as we all know, it is very close to the Hindi word chai, which is used all over the India to refer to tea. How did tea first come to India? Historians think that tea had been known in India as a medicinal plant since ancient times. But tea was not drunk for pleasure until the British began to establish plantations in the 19th century. In the 1770s, the British East India Company made several unsuccessful attempts to grow tea in Bhutan and Assam with seeds from China. Although these attempts failed, the botanist Robert Bruce in 1823 discovered tea plants growing wild in the upper Brahmaputra Valley. Now in May 1838, the first Indian tea from Assam was sent to England for public sale. Now since then, India has gone on to become one of the leading producers of the tea in the world. Tea lovers claim that tea may be able to reduce the risk of cancer, control blood pressure, fight viruses in our body, and actually help us live longer. Our body produces chemicals called free radicals. They can damage our body and our health. Tea contains antioxidants called flavonoids. Scientists believe these help to protect our system against free radicals. For many people, tea is a popular drink to have with friends. In many countries around the world, tea drinking is an important social occasion. Japan, China, Russia, Korea have special tea ceremonies and traditions. Now, these ceremonies give people the time to relax and enjoy the taste and the smell of the tea. Most people in Japan belong to a tea club where they go every week to take part in the tea ceremony. Ordinary people also feel that tea ceremonies are a spiritual occasion that are closely associated with their religion. Tea, they say, is a healthy, enjoyable and stimulating drink, full of good qualities. It reduces loneliness and calms your heart. It is a comfort in everyday life. Many Koreans today still have tea ceremonies for important occasions, including special birthdays and anniversaries. In most areas of China, the tea is made in small clay teapots. Now, at tea ceremonies, cups are only half filled. The Chinese believe that the rest of the cup must be filled with friendship and affection. In Russia, tea is made and served in samovars, a special Russian tea kettle made of metal. Vietnam produces special varieties of tea such as lotus tea and jasmine tea. In Japan, tea is made using powdered green tea called matcha. The tea is mixed with boiled water using a bamboo whisk and served in small bowls. And how about India? A cup of tea is offered to any guest or visitor as a token of hospitality, even in humblest of homes. Now, most Indians like their tea hot with a good deal of milk and sugar in it. Now, in rainy season, it is brewed with ginger to give it additional medicinal properties. Others add spices like cardamom, cloves, and mace to add to it its taste and flavor. Tea is a must after a plate of spicy snacks, especially in the morning and evenings. Some connoisseurs relish delicately flavored jasmine tea, green tea, lemon tea, and even iced tea. How about you? Friends, we will see the detailed explanation of this whole lesson in the next video. So if you haven't subscribed this educational channel, please subscribe it in order to get the intimation of the next videos. So thank you for listening this video.